Welcome back to a spooky episode of Cooking with Reagan. I'm your host, Chef Reagan. Come on, guys. Did you really think I was gonna do a cringy Halloween-themed episode? No, I have a great recipe for you today. Today, we're gonna make tacos, but not just any tacos. We're gonna make walking tacos. But again, not just walking tacos, because the individual bags of Doritos were way too expensive, so I just got a big family-sized bag. So, here's your first ingredient. So, the first ingredient we're gonna need is beef, ground beef. Now, I have 10 pounds of ground beef here, and 10 pounds of ground beef is expensive, so I split the cost with my mom. But I'm gonna make 5 pounds of this for all you guys. Our next ingredient, PUBG Doritos.
PUBG.
Again, they were on sale at the grocery store, so that's what you guys get. Look, cheese, sour cream. That's our final ingredient. I had no idea how expensive cheese was until you're trying to buy every taco ingredient for $10. You really learn to appreciate the value of a dollar. So we have all of our ingredients here. We have our beef. Our Doritos, sour cream, and cheese. Now, let's see all of the cooking utensils we need. So, not a whole lot to cook this. A pan and a wooden spoon, it's all you need. Let's get right into it. So I lied, we need one more ingredient. I have an ice cream scooper, but today it's a ground beef scooper, and we're gonna start scooping out beef. Smooth. Just scooping out beef. More beef. Are we beefing right now? Yeah, we are beefing right now. We're ground beefing right now.
What?
So because there's not a whole lot of steps to this, I'm gonna draw out every step and make it as unfunny as possible. So be warned. We're gonna have funny music playing. Don't worry. Oh, my bad, I didn't see you there. So, our one step of the night, our one of two steps of the night, is to saute our ground beef. And you know how you saute ground beef? Beef? You break it up into small chunks and you heat it up till it's cooked. And so I don't give anyone salmon vanilla poisoning, because that would be bad. And that would be bad for ratings, and it wouldn't get me the budget I need. So, we're gonna saute the beef, and we're gonna have a nice beef sauteing montage, just like last episode. You almost done with that?
Hey.
Man, I hate when people break into my kitchen and try making my food for me. So anyway, we're almost done here with our ground beef. And I've been told, and I don't know who told me this, and she didn't exactly seem like an expert, but I was told that I should drain the fat out of this, whatever that means. So I guess I just like, I don't know. Hold it over the sink. That's what we're gonna do when it's done cooking, so stay tuned. All right, so we have our strainer, and now we have to get all the fat out of this. I should probably put that in the refrigerator, and I have to move the pumpkin out of my sink. Okay, that's done. Now, grab the ground beef. And little by little, dump it in. Very close. You're getting adventurous there, huh? Huh, Chris? All right, so. All the fat's almost gone. I want to leave a little bit because, you know, flavor. You know, I'm not too upset with that. So, I'm going to put this back because I want a little bit of fat. Sizzle. I'm going to pick this up without burning myself because we don't like burns here at Cooking with Reagan. I'm going to dump this back. Ooh, okay, that's hot. Into here. And now I have to do some light reading on the back of my taco instructions on how to actually put the seasoning in correctly. Get out. Stop. Why'd you break into my kitchen? Okay, so I did some reading. I remembered how. Thank you, Mr. Hassler. And eyes are up here. It says I need 2/3 of a cup of water. You want to get down level with it, because that's very important. Slowly fill it up till it's about 2/3 of the way full. It's a little bit over, but we'll live. So, my reading comprehension's not good, so. Stir in water and seasoning mix, and then heat to boiling. All right, so it looks like that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna open this up. We opened it up. Now we're going to spread it around here. Ooh, I can taste the spice already. So, that was supposed to be only for a pound of taco meat, but I don't like spicy stuff, so that's all you guys get. So now we stir. All right, so I love you guys, and I would feel really badly if you had bland taco meat. So while looking at this, I kind of realized it needs a little bit more seasoning, so I'm just gonna put a little bit more in, just a little bit. And now we're gonna add another half cup of water, just because, you know, I want it to taste good for you guys. And as funny and entertaining as the show is supposed to be, I hope you all kind of learned something out of it. And if that lesson is to not be like me, that's an okay lesson to pull out of this, but I'd prefer you learn how to cook. So now, we're gonna turn our burner back up, and now we're gonna do the montage. Hey, Ashley, you mind being my B-roll real quick?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
Yep.
Ow. Okay, well, it's done for now. It's done. So now I'm gonna put this in a casserole dish, put some saran wrap over it, and I'll see you all tomorrow, where I let viewers like you taste test my masterful creation. So, right now, I'm here with 3 BV1 students because they were the only 3 in the room, so here we go. All right, bony apple feet. Eat the pie.
It's good, Reagan.
You just took a bite of Doritos.
Did I?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm certain.
That's President Vina.
Mom, I'm really feeling these. These are really good. I give these a 10 out of 10. These are the best crawling tacos I've ever eaten.
They look good.
I'm not reading off
the
script.
This is why I just ate the Doritos.
I love these honest reactions.
No,
100% correct response. Okay, on to the next person.
That's why it exists.
We are on our way down to the office to make the administration eat our tacos and hopefully bring up the fact that I had to pay for all of this out of my own pocket, and I'd really prefer if I don't have to do that anymore. So I'll see you in a little bit. All right, so the office was a bust for now. We're gonna go back because Mr. Warbach loves good food. So right now, we're just trying to bother teachers who are kind of busy but don't mind not being busy so they can test some delicious food.
Enjoy.
I feel like I need to like crunch it up or something. It's not really a walking taco. More of a sitting taco.
Yeah, I've been calling them crawling tacos.
Crawling tacos?
Yeah.
Okay,
so.
You get a little bit of everything on the spin.
Oh yeah.
If I can crush this chip. A little cold, but.
We've been walking around for a little bit, yeah.
But good flavor. The sour cream makes it nice and creamy. Very good.
Thank you. All right, you can share with them now.
Okay.
We're eating. Oh, I was gonna curtsy.
All right, so now we're here with Mr. Dresch. Mr. Dresch, enjoy.
Honestly, it's probably the worst thing I've ever eaten.
Okay. Mrs. Haynes.
What is this?
Okay, so we're filming a Cooking with Reagan episode, right? And I made tacos, and I'm trying to get teachers to try some, Would you like to taste this?
Sure.
Do you want sour cream and cheese?
Yes, please.
All right.
I'm so full. I just had a big salad from Sheets.
Well, this has ground beef, and ground beef is better than salad, so.
That's plenty. Oh my goodness.
I want it to be flavorful.
But did you use Doritos?
Yes.
They're not spicy Doritos, are they?
No.
Okay.
I apologize. We've been walking around for a class
so
right now.
So it's cold.
Possibly. Do you have a? Oh crap! I need a spoon.
I have a fork.
Oh, you have a fork? Perfect. Okay. And you know, we can leave this part in. I don't like honest answers.
You don't like honest answers.
So,
I know, I thought you guys were bringing me like a birthday cake because I've been bugging Malachi and your Kelly, like, of all the years I'm here and nobody ever recognizes my birthday and my birthday's tomorrow.
Birthday's tomorrow.
And I was like, you better.
Okay, we could bring possibly bring you in a cupcake as a
bonus. I don't need a cupcake.
For my TikTok.
Just to announce it.
All right, so.
Because there have been days I've come into this building and nobody's even recognized my birthday and I've worked for 25 years.
I will make sure to come with you happy birthday.
Okay, I'm gonna taste this.
Okay.
It's very good.
Thank you, thank you.
It needs heated up, but it's very, very good.
Yeah.
I like the flavor.
Thank you.
It's a good flavor.
All right, I appreciate it. Thank you. Mm-hmm. You can keep it or throw it at Mrs. Junior's.
He says I can throw it at one of you.
No, all of them. I need one more teacher.
What?
I'm going to put dramatic music right now. Keep the dramatic music. Teachers.
What is this, dude?
It's Cooking with Reagan on the go. Do you want to taste test?
Sure, I'll take a taste test.
Can we do it in the classroom? It's very loud out here.
Sure.
All right, we'll come to you. It's we're off.
It's like a Mexican dish of some sort.
It's
Doritos?
As I've been calling them, crawling tacos, because.
But they're Doritos.
Yeah, it's like walking tacos, but hold on. Do you want sour cream and cheese?
Oh my goodness, yeah.
Oh, we have all the fixings.
Wow.
That fit in the budget, which wasn't much.
It was actually...
Well, yeah, if you're using Doritos instead of like actual nut, but that's okay.
No budget.
It was out of my pocket.
You know, they put Cheese Whiz on Philly cheesesteak, so...
And that's delicious.
It is.
Chris!
What's up, dog?
Oh my gosh!
Enjoy.
Okay, so I gotta get a piece here that's got the sour cream on it.
Mmm, yummy.
Oh man, I can't believe I'm being filmed. Don't watch me eat.
Look away. Everyone look away.
Scrubs.
Now what's the beef? Is it?
It's ground beef and whatever seasoning was the cheapest at the grocery store.
I don't think I got any beef. I gotta get some with beef on.
Alright.
And then I'm done, I promise.
Okay.
So. That's pretty good.
Pretty good? Alright, 1 out of 10, what are you gonna say?
We'll go with 8.5.
Well, okay, I'll accept that. Thank you.
Only because it's, you know, it's Doritos, but. But yeah, 8.5, absolutely.
Doritos are delicious, but okay. All right, I have to take this back and I'll be back for Mr. Warbach microwaved it himself because the idea of cold tacos didn't seem appealing. So, enjoy. Mr. Grump, do you want to get in on this as well?
We got it.
We have.
Here, you can have this spoon because look, I have my own.
Why don't we're going to eat off the same.
No, plate. Look at this here, I have my own.
But what are we trying to do? Why are we both eating?
Because I need to get people's honest opinions of it.
Did you make something here?
Oh yeah, I made this. This is the Cooking with Reagan segment.
But what did you cook, Reagan?
Ground beef with taco seasoning.
I brought my own fork here.
Am I on film right now?
Yes, you are. And then Doritos.
Okay, so walking taco.
Yeah,
we'll be
but
calling it something else.
It's crawling.
Is that sour cream?
What do we call it?
Yes.
Okay, I didn't know that was sour cream. I thought that was extra
crawling
cheese.
Crawling taco.
Who makes it a crawling taco?
I call it that because it's on life support. It's crawling at this point.
No,
don't listen to that.
I'm a big fan of, I think I'm a big fan of crawling tacos, to be honest with you.
All right.
Yeah, it's pretty solid.
Mr. Warbach?
What kind of cheese is this?
The four cheese Mexican blend from the grocery store.
It was a good decision.
Thank you, thank you.
Yeah. All right, guys.
No, this is.
Appreciate it. I'll be nice and full for my meeting.
This is a service we're offering.
All right, guys. Thank you.
Thank you.
I also like it. I brought my own fork to get a better scoop. That's why Mr. Croft was allowed to eat with a spoon there. I'm not a sour cream guy, so I'm going to stay away from the center. I'm just going to eat from the edges.
All right.
You really can't beat a Dorito. Like, you can't mess up a Dorito, so.
Oh, I can try, but I appreciate the confidence.
Well, you know, do I have to decide if this is better or worse than the chicken patty you put in spaghetti sauce last time?
If you would like to, and then we'll just do a throwback to that real quick. Mm.
So what if I told you that the chicken in this is just a chicken patty from the grocery store?
Well, what it does is it shows me that there's a little bit of ingenuity behind this plate of food, and the presentation gives it a 5-star restaurant feeling, and you know what? Sometimes presentation is half the battle. Chicken patty and spaghetti, or chicken parm, whatever you want to call it, I like it.
Okay.
I'm going to go, I like the cheese and the taco meat and the Doritos. I'm going to go with this over the chicken parm.
All right, perfect. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Reagan. This is fantastic.
Do you just want the rest of this other than the sour cream?
Yeah, I'm going to eat the whole thing.
All right, thank you. Have a good day. Okay, so I'm doing a bit of a Glover on the Go themed ending here. So the reviews were raving for the tacos. Except by Mr. Dresch, but that's okay. That one hurt a little bit. But everyone loved the tacos, almost everyone. And yeah, I forgot the ingredients when I did the ingredients at the beginning, and I forgot some of the cookware that you needed. But that's not important, because as I've said before, it's not about the journey, it's about the destination. People liked them, and that's the important part. And like I did last time, I'll tell you who you can make these for. You can make these for anyone. You have a fundraiser you need to do, make this. Your mom is angry at you because you didn't clean her room. You might not want to make her this, but you could if you wanted to. That's all for Cooking with Reagan today. Have a great day, everyone. This is Chef Reagan, signing off. Woo!